Okay, today I just want to address this very important issue. If you watch my video right during the circuit breaker period, right, I said like I feel that all the rent resale prices, all these things will be quite stable, it won't drop. I've said that rental will drop, okay? But now looking at the statistics, right, it looks like rental is not dropping but increasing. Then I ask myself, why is rental increasing? What is the thing that I didn't manage to foresee? Okay, I realized that this part on the Malaysian not able to cross the border and work every day is actually a very, very crucial part. Because for the past 1 to 2 months after the circuit breaker, there is a lot of Malaysians that is forced to rent. Okay, I wouldn't say that the Malaysians forced to rent, but people that employ these Malaysians to work for them, the companies are also being forced to rent. Because today, if you still want your people to actually work in Singapore, you cannot expect them to drive across the border every day up and down. The COVID situation, right, doesn't allow that step. You see, okay, previously you will see a lot of Malaysians, they go home, go back to JB, then they come back, go back to JB, then they come back. But now, right, you realize that they cannot do that because there's this 14 days and all these things. Okay, I won't elaborate all this. I think you all have read the newspaper and already know a lot about it. Now, the main thing is a lot of Malaysian people that's working in Singapore, they have to rent. So because of this, right, rental market actually go tobalik. The rental market, actually, I thought that it would go down, but it actually went up. Okay, especially the HDB market, I would have to say, especially the HDB market, because many of the people renting are actually Malaysians. And also I realized that the high-end rental market, right, the people are downgrading. Okay, so if you look at a renter around 3,000 plus, below 4k or 4.5k, right, that portion of renter is actually doing very well. Because even a lot of expatriates, right, that's working in Singapore, they told me that they are prepared for any recession or any aftermath of this COVID situation. So they are downgrading. Previously, some tenants from the condos are going to the HDB. Previously, tenants from the central condo area are going more to the outskirts. From 4,000 plus renter, they are going to the 3,000 plus renter. So there is this shift in the situation, and this shift, right, has created a high transaction volume. So you realize that the rental transaction volume for the past few months has been very high because a lot of people are shifting. A lot of people decide not to renew. Even if they renew, they decide to negotiate for a better rental. I see a lot of units, right, that was once renting so high, now they start to rent so high. So the more expensive condo renter, the prices are dropping. The more outskirt and cheaper, around the 2,000 to 3,000 range, the price is actually quite stable, and we actually see an increase in volume. And the HDB side, there is a lack of supply. The demand has increased, even some prices have increased. Okay, these prices has increased, right, doesn't mean that HDB rental is more expensive. Let me explain to you why I say so. It's because a lot of people, right, the rent price is being determined by the tenant. If today the owner decides to rent to a group of maybe only 2 or 3 in the family, they may rent at a lower price. But today, if the landlord decides to rent to like 5 people or 6 people, they will feel that there's more wear and tear to the house, you know. They will ask for a higher rental price. So this is the slight difference that you will see. So like I told you, a lot of HDB units are going out to the Malaysian working in Singapore. You won't see like 3 Malaysians in 1 HDB flat. They will try to max it out like maybe 5, especially when the companies is a company lease. They want to cut costs, they want to save their money. They will go for the maximum, which is 6. So when you go for 6, right, it also means that the rental price is actually relatively higher than we trying to rent out to a family. Okay, so these are some of the situations that's happening. That if you look at the situation, you realize that, hey Aaron, you say that the price is dropping but the price is not, you say that there's no foreigners coming in, but it's not the case. Yes, correct, I agree, it's not the case, because I realize that I miss out the part whereby the Malaysians are forced to stay in Singapore to work. they cannot do the back and forth every day from the causeway. So I think this part is actually quite amazing, because the volume of this group of people is actually very, very big. It's big enough to push the statistics of the rental market up. Okay, so that's it for today's video. In this whole series, this new series, right, I will be actually touching on a lot of things that's happening on the ground. I don't know if you should call it a post-COVID or maybe just a post-circuit breaker situation, because actually prices has actually slightly increased, volume has shot tremendously, and what is the real thing that is really happening on the ground? Then you gotta watch out for the next episode. So hit the like button, subscribe button, and see you in the next episode. Bye bye.